it's believed that there are fewer than 13 Tuskegee Airmen left out of the nearly 1,000 pilots who fought in World War II.
Aaron Ivory's here with the story of one who lived out his final days here in Chicago and got one last wish come true.
Yeah, Tuskegee Airmen. This is just an amazing story. His name's Jack Lyle, and he really lived an extraordinary life, worth honoring pretty much in every way. But his family wasn't able to grant him his final wish until yesterday.
He was a hero when people said, you know, you can't do this, and that just made him stronger. He said, watch my smoke.
Lieutenant Jack Lyle was many things, a husband, father, author, and sailor. But unless you asked, you would never know he was one of the few men who made history back in 1941.
There could be a million people around, but you would never know that he was a Tuskegee Airman, because he would never mention it.
As the first African-American military pilots, the Red Tails marked a pivotal point, laying the groundwork for integration in all military branches.
People viewed people differently. Although we all bleed red blood, doesn't matter what color you are, he knew who he was.
Years later, Jack turned his attention from the blue sky to the water.
We were just good buddies all through the years. After he got through sailing, he would be resting there.
A bench he used so much, Jackson Park Yacht Club put his name on it. At 98, he had outlived every fellow Tuskegee pilot he knew, until his own health took a turn for the worse.
I asked what his last wish would be, and she said he has not seen Lake Michigan in so long. His dying wish would be to sit on his favorite bench.
Where he could see Lake Michigan one more time.
His hospice care team arranged for an ambulance to bring him there later that week.
I just couldn't count the days, you know, but he was getting weaker.
Lieutenant Lyle passed 2 days later, never making it to that bench overlooking the lake.
I'm sorry.
To fulfill that wish will always be on my mind.
In honor of our veteran, John Jack Lyle.
Yesterday, that wish was finally granted.
And I'm going to pin you on Jack's behalf.
The season's hospice team arranging for a special ceremony at Jack's bench in his honor.
That means the world for me, because no one can compare. He was a real man.
A Tuskegee Airman's dying wish to see the lake one last time, fulfilled in spirit.
Oh, he's here. Yeah, he's always in my heart and always on my mind. America.
And this Monday, Memorial Day, Jack's family will take his sailboat out one last time to spread his ashes in Lake Michigan, really forever connecting this here with the open sky and the water that he loves so much. So just a really touching tribute to a man who just had an amazing life.
And a reminder of all their sacrifice, too.
Exactly.
Thanks, Aaron.
Thank you, Aaron. Let's turn it now.